The U.S. military has downed a Syrian fighter jet in the northern province of Raqqa. Syrian army said the plane was targeted in the town of Ras Safa, at some 40 kilometers southwest of Raqqa's provincial capital. The attack came amid Syrian troops' advances into the province. The army says that the plane crashed and the pilot's missing. Damascus condemned the move as a flagrant attack, which took place while the plane was on a combat mission against Daesh terrorists. The U.S. military confirmed the attack, accusing the Syrian side of bombing Washington-backed militants. Meanwhile, clashes have reportedly erupted south of Raqqa between Syrian troops and U.S.-backed Syrian Democratic Forces. Interesting story here, kind of disturbing. We're joined out of Dominica by Mr. Ken O'Keefe, former U.S. Marine. Mr. Ken O'Keefe, help us understand this.
So as I was saying before being cut off, there is this plan, Odi Dinan's strategy for Israel in the 1980s. It lays out very specifically target number one was Saddam Hussein. They've taken out Saddam Hussein. Iraq is not a failure. That's all part of a long-term, decades-long plan. The rest of the plan involves getting the Arabs to, quote, bleed each other, to sow the seeds of sectarian hatred so that these weakened, fractured states will be able to be overrun. There'll be a provocation that will be used, and we're seeing these things heating up now. And of course, ISIS, as I mentioned before, stands for Israeli Secret Intelligence Service. ISIS, Al-Qaeda, Al-Nusra Front have never attacked Israel. How conspicuous is that? How much more obvious does it need to be? They also don't attack Saudi Arabia as well. No coincidence there either. Libya's been taken out. Iraq was taken out in terms of Saddam Hussein. And we know that Iraq has so much suffering and pain, millions of orphans, millions of refugees. They're trying to pick up the pieces, but they became a home for ISIS. And they're still there, although that thank God for the efforts of the people of Iraq, the military, to get them out. And Syria, well, we know what's happening in Syria. The long-term goal is what's called Greater Israel. Israel is meant to expand and be the next empire. And America is being set alight. America is being sacrificed. There always is a transfer of imperial power. The empire never actually leaves. It simply morphs into something else. And the plan of these psychopaths is to have Israel be the next empire. Now, what's really key here is for American service members. Back in 2013, many may recall that very courageous service members held up signs in their uniforms and said, I did not join the U.S. military to fight for Al-Qaeda in Syria. Now, but that was 2013, pre-ISIS. Now, it is very critical for American service members to now know, you are going to be called on to fight for ISIS. You are going to be called on to fight for ISIS. Against those who are legitimately fighting against ISIS, i.e. Iran, Hezbollah, Syria, and Iraqi forces as well. We are funding, supporting, and coddling ISIS. We just did a deal for $350 billion to Saudi Arabia. Everybody knows that Saudi Arabia, through their Wahhabi doctrine and their financing, is the main source of terrorism in the region. It is absolutely insulting to the intelligence of all of us that Iran keeps getting plastered across the American and Western media as the bastion of support for terrorism when everybody knows that it's Saudi Arabia. And we just gifted them with $350 billion worth of weapons, which will be in the hands of ISIS, just like the American-made weapons, which are in the hands of ISIS. And this is the story. And until we face this fact and really do what we need to do, this is gonna get worse and worse. So I'm hopeful that more and more Americans are finally seeing this. It's hard, it's bitter pill to take, but ultimately your government is a monolithic government. It doesn't matter whether it's Donald Trump, Barack Obama, George Bush, Bill Clinton, Bush before him, it's always the same, always the same. The only difference is some minor changes or minor differences in domestic policy. But in terms of international policy and the war-making machine, that never stops. And guess who benefits from all of this most profoundly? Just like Netanyahu said on 9/11 or just after 9/11, we're benefiting from one thing and one thing only, the attacks on 9/11. Israel is the beneficiary of this. Israel owns the U.S. government. Literally, they own it. So all of you U.S. members, U.S. service members in particular, it is time now to seriously disobey the orders. You need to disobey the orders. You cannot fight for ISIS. You cannot do that. That's not being patriotic. You swore to uphold the U.S. Constitution. So, you know, it is so obvious at this point. I just don't even know how anybody could ignore the facts.
All right, well, thank you, Ken, for joining us, or rejoining us. That was Ken O'Keefe, former U.S. Marine, joining us out of Dominica.